into another video. Now, right off the bat, I want to say this video will contain spoilers for Ninjago Season 15, Episode 4. So if you have not seen it, I highly recommend clicking away and coming back after you've seen this episode, because this is something you do not want spoiled. Now, with that being said, let's get into the video. What is going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. As usual, we are here to review the brand new episode of Ninjago Season 15, and I cannot wait to get into this, especially towards the end bit of this video. But first off, we gotta start off with the earlier stuff in the episode. Now, the overall plot of this episode was Nia and Maya go out to search for a power source after the Hydra bounty lost power in the last episode, and that is pretty much the plot of this episode, is them going to get power. But a lot happens in this episode, especially for it being episode 4. The first thing I want to get into is Nia telling it to Maya. I love that. Maya has been annoying me for the past couple episodes. I just don't like her character, and I really don't like that she's in the season that much, and Nia finally said, "What I was thinking, go away, Maya, I don't want you here," and that made me happy. So yeah, that was a really good thing I liked about this episode, just a little thing. Getting into more little things before we get into the big stuff, the Hydromechs looked really sick this episode. I really enjoyed those. Those were pretty cool. Again, Maya was really annoying, and the animation I thought was really good this episode. Like, it stood out at a lot of parts, and Wildbrain is definitely stepping up their game in terms of animation for this show than we got in the previous seasons. And I think that's a really good thing, as Wildbrain has stepped up the level of action Ninjago can go to. In previous seasons, up until about season 8, the action looked about was pretty stiff and didn't flow the best. And now with these new seasons, it's flowing a lot more, and it almost looks like I could be watching an anime. And I absolutely love that Wildbrain is doing this with the animation. Getting into spoiler stuff, we had Prince Kalmar, or Kalmar, whatever his name is, and wow, what an entrance to the series. When I say I loved his entrance, I loved it, man. It was great. If you haven't seen my reaction to the episode, go check it out. I absolutely loved this episode, and that was due to this man's entrance. He ain't playing around. He's already ready to kill off his men. He's like, bro, if you don't get this done, someone else will. And I'm just like, bro, my guy, how are you being introduced and you're this bad at, like, I can't with this guy. And this could be my favorite villain. So far from what I've seen from him, I've absolutely loved him, and his introduction is better than any villain we've gotten in previous Ninjago seasons. And finally, we get to see stuff from Wubjira, and she's just chilling there, and we learn that this guy's trying to wake her up. Now, we don't really know for what reason as of yet, but it can obviously be for some reason to take over the world, or Ninjago, or something like that along the lines as most Ninjago villains. But it was finally cool to see some movement and see where Wubjira is at, as the last episode we only saw her in the bottom of the sea. At the end of the island was the last time we saw her, and we only heard her in mention before in season 8, so I'm really curious on what's gonna be going on with her and why is she such a huge threat to Ninjago. And obviously, how and why is she messing with Nia's powers? And let me say, bro, there's this one shot in this episode where Wubjira sent like out an energy blast and it hit Nia, and man, that had me like on jumping in my seat. I hope nothing bad happened to Nia's powers or anything. She hit her head off the mech at the end of the episode, so we don't know too much about what's going on with her, but I can assume that they do want to steal her powers, and I think that is a possibility to happen this season. But if it does happen, I do think she'll get it back. Anyways, there's a lot I loved about this episode, and I'm really excited to see what happens with this villain, and if that did wake up Wubjira or not, or if they're gonna have to use Nia's powers to wake her up or not. I'm really excited to see where this goes, and I have a feeling the next couple episodes, it's just going to be keep getting better and better and better. All in all, I'd give this episode a 10. I absolutely loved it. Everything about it was just great, and even Maya wasn't too annoying this episode. And that gives it bonus points, man. With that being said, if you guys did enjoy this review, please be sure to leave a like and subscribe for weekly Ninjago reviews on the newest episodes. And I'm even thinking of doing some other content about the show, you know, talking more about it and giving some theories out there. So if you guys do want to see videos like those, you know, leave a subscribe. And of course, a like to let me know that you guys do enjoy these videos. And my Instagram, Twitter, all that's down below. If you guys have any questions you want to shoot to me on Twitter, I'll be doing some polls and stuff over there. So yeah, it's fun times over there. And thank you all for watching. And as usual, I will see you guys in the next video. Peace out.